You have to make a decision, and then I'll show you the right way, and then hopefully you remember it. Okay, not just for your test, but from now on. Okay, 30 more seconds. Yeah, is there not any odor? Yep. Okay, here we go. All of this is on your test. So take a look. Does anybody know on number one, do I add them or do I multiply them? Okay, you do multiply them, that's correct. It's called a power to a power. I want you to write that down. Power to a power. You multiply. So 3 times 3. This one's going to be n to the 9th power. If you put a 6, it's wrong. Okay. Any questions on that? A power to a power, you multiply. On the next one, you have the same base, so you add these. There's a difference between these two. This one you multiply, this one you add. Is everybody clear on that? Memorize that, okay? All right, next. This one right here, you have 7 X's at the top, so I'm going to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These I'm going to drop to the bottom because it's a negative. So put y, y. This one is going to stay at the bottom. So put x, x, x. However, this one is a negative, so move it to the top. So put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Any questions about what I did? If it's a negative, you need to move it up or down depending. Okay, now you reduce. So here I have 3, so I'm going to knock it out with 3 of those. Here I have 2, so I'm going to knock it out with 2 of those. So on your test tomorrow, you have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's going to be x to the 4th, y to the 3rd, over what? I forgot to cancel those out. Over 1, so just leave it as this. And let me double check my work and make sure. All right, those 3 canceled, those 2 canceled, and that looks right. Any questions on how to do that problem? No, because you had 5 negatives on the bottom and you moved them to the top and they became positive. You with me? All right. The last one is called a 2-step equation, so watch carefully. Draw your line, circle your X. You have to be able to do this. Can anybody tell me what to do first?
Add 0.5 to
each side. So I'm going to add 0.5 to both sides. So I'm going to get 3 over 5X. Very good. Now on your calculator, I think that's 2.4. Is that correct?
Yeah.
All right, is everybody clear? All right, what do I do now? Multiply by 5. And then what do I do? Divide by what? Divide by 3. So 2.4 times 5. So I get 12. And then I divide by 3. And I get 4. So everybody clear on how to do the 2-step equation? All right, next.
I need to double check my calculator. If you got 860 on my calculator, I did.
Okay. Put away your bell work. Try this one.
We need the microphone.
No.
Work those 2 problems, please.
Let's see the
Yeah, it's on a different sheet. I'm not picking this up. Tomorrow I will pick up your practice test. Now this was on your practice test, and both of these, or at least that last one, is in geometry. Now let me show you, okay, since you had it yesterday, let me go over it with you. You have the same base, which is 9, and you're multiplying, so you add these exponents. That's it. It's just real simple. So 10 plus 1 is 11, 12, 13, 14. On your test, you should have 9 to the 14th power. Is everybody clear on that one? Now, how would I do that on a calculator? Let me just show you. On this calculator, you'd press 9, and then you'd hit this XY key, which is right here. So you'd press the XY key, and then you'd press 14, and you get that. It's times 10 to the 13th power. Real huge numbers. Okay. All right, next. These are called vertical angles. So on your test tomorrow, you set them equal to each other. So you put 5a plus 6 is equal to 6a minus 11. Any questions about what I did? Is everybody clear on that? Okay, so now, do I have more a's on the left or more a's on the right?
More a's on the right.
So you want to get rid of this one. So you want to subtract 5a from both sides. So you're going to get 6 is equal to a minus 11. And now what do I do? Add 11.
But why is it a? Because you're, oh, it's 1a.
Okay. Yeah, 6 minus 5 is 1a. Is everybody clear on how to get that answer? All right, let's move on. Let's talk about the work now. So get your packet out, your review sheet. All right, look up here. It says the quotient. Quotient means division. So what we're going to do, you need one?
Yes.
Who else needs one?
Anybody else?
All right, look up here and watch. The word quotient means division. So on any test you take, if they say quotient, you're going to put the quotient of 4 times a number. A number is x or n. So it's going to be 4n divided by 10. Any questions on that? The quotient means division.
Can you
okay.
put an X?
You can put an X if you want.
Okay.
All right, let's go on. The next one. It says write the number 0.2 in a fraction form. Well, this is 10. So it's 2 over 10, which reduces to 1 over 5. Any questions on number 2? It's in the 10th position. Okay. The next one right here, we didn't know. Someone said it was mode or mean or something. Anyway, this one says find the mean, so you got to add them all up. So let's do that kind of quickly. So on your test tomorrow, you're going to say 17 plus 37 plus 36 plus 37 plus 35 plus 27 plus 21 plus 28. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Press equals and divide by 8.
Do you always divide by 8?
Well, if there's 8 numbers.
Oh, so you divide by how many numbers?
Correct. Correct. So the mean or the average is going to be 29.75. Is everybody clear on that?
Yeah.
Now the range, you're going to take the biggest number. Well, here, the biggest number looks like 37, I guess. So you take the biggest number minus the smallest number. So for the range, it's going to be 37 minus
17.
Thank you. So it looks like 20 then. The range is 20. Any questions on what I did or how I did it? All right, let's go on. All of this is on your test. Now, you don't have to know what I'm saying because you can use your calculator. Look here. Press 9, put a negative in front of it, and then press plus 4. You know your answer is negative 5. Now, I would rather you do that without a calculator, so look up here. Do I have more minuses or do I have more pluses? How many more minuses? Yeah, it's easy if you think about it in those terms, okay? This one right here, a negative times a negative is going to make that a plus. So change that to a plus. Now I'm going to use my calculator on this one because it's got decimals on it. So watch. On this one, I'm going to press 2.5 and put a negative. So 2.5 and put a negative plus 4.1 plus 1.6. On your test, you should have 3.2. Let's keep moving. This one is a fraction, and on a fraction, you got to find the same denominator. Okay? So look up here. I don't know what it is, so I'm just going to use them both. So I'm going to put this one times 9, and I'm going to put this one times 8. It may not be the lowest, but oh well, I'll reduce it. Any questions so far? So I'm going to get a negative 8 over 72 minus 45 over 72. Now these signs are the same, so you got to add it up. So you're going to get a negative, and when you add that up, I think that's 53 over 72. Any questions on that?
Negative 52.
It is a negative, correct. So everybody got that? Now you should try to reduce it by twos and threes and fives, but let's keep moving. This one right here, you want to collect like terms. Well, this one right here has a square, and this one has a square. So circle it and add them up. So that's going to be 4.2, I think. This one right here and that one right there is going to be 5.5. Take that back. 6 minus 4 is 2.5. So it's going to be 2.5 minus this one, minus one more. So it looks like it's going to be plus 1.5n. Let's see, 4 and 1 makes 5, so 6 minus 5 is 1. Any questions on how I did number 8?
Why don't you add the exponents? Like, why wouldn't it be like 4.2 and 1.5?
All right, when you add or subtract, you leave the exponents alone. You don't do anything with the exponents. It's only when you multiply or divide that you have to do something with your exponents. Is that clear? All right, good question. All right, let's keep moving. Anything to the zero power you were taught is 1. This one we had on the bell work. You have the same base, so you add up your exponents. 11, it's 9 to the 14th power. Okay? This one right here, you have the same base. How much is 8 minus 8? So it's 844 to the 0 power, which equals 1. Any questions on number 11? You add the exponents because you're multiplying. Okay? All right, on the next one, which is way up here, it's a power to a power. So we had this one on the bell work. It's going to be 3 times 3, so it's 9. The next one, do I have more A's at the top or more A's at the bottom?
Bottom.
How many at the bottom?
Two.
Two more. Any questions on my answer for number 13? Now look, if that confuses you, expand it out because you don't want to miss it. Okay, when you click that button on March 21st, they had to move the date. This one right here is, because you guys don't have school on the 20th, 3, 6, 7. So these 5 knock out with those 5, and you're left with 2 on the bottom. So you have to put a 1 on the top. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? Yes or no? All right. The next one is similar to what you had on the bell work. So I'm going to take all of these M's and put them at the bottom. So put M to the 11th on the bottom. Put this N on the bottom. So put N to the 12th. These two you got to move up, so move it as 8 and move it as 24. Now before I finish it, any questions about what I did so far? Is everybody clear on that? All right, do I have more m's at the top or more m's at the bottom? How many more at the bottom? So put 3. Do I have more n's at the top or at the bottom? Any questions on what I did on that problem? Everybody clear on that concept? You could expand it out, but these are kind of big. Evaluate this equation. So it's b minus 2a minus c. And then they tell you what everything is. So b is 4, so put a 4 here. A is 7, so put a 7 there. And c is a negative 3. Notice how I put parentheses in there. It's real important that you do that, so watch. A negative times a negative makes a positive. Any questions about what I did so far? You have 2 negatives. Anyway, this is going to be 7, so it's going to be 7 minus 14. On your calculator, 7 minus 14 should be that. Any questions on how to evaluate it? Notice how I put parentheses and then put my numbers in there. If you do that, you will eliminate some of those negative problems that some of you have. Put parentheses and then put your numbers in there. I'm telling you, that will work. All right, look right here. You're switching them. This one is switched. So the one, they switched positions, so it's commutative property. Commutative property of equal of addition. What was your comment?
You're adding, so it'd be addition.
Right. Commutative property because you're switching them. Is everybody clear on that? All right. Commutative switch. Put CS. Commutative switch is the way I memorize it. The next one, excuse me, let me see what they did here. I guess we got to solve that one. So look up here. Distribute. So it's going to be 6y minus 12 equals 6. Any questions so far? How do I get y by itself?
Add
12 and do what?
Divide by
6. Divide by 6. So I'm going to add 12 and then divide by 6. Any questions on that right there?
Is everybody clear? All right, let's keep moving.
Now look, I told the other classes this. I'm going to tell you the same thing. Okay? I told them that if they make an A, whoever makes an A on this test tomorrow, I will either give you 2 A's or I'll drop that first test grade. And some of you didn't do real well on that first test grade. So if you can really do well on this one, an A, it's got to be an A, then I'll help you out. All right, so draw your line. We had this one already. You're going to add 0.5, multiply by 5, and then divide by 3. This was the bell work. So 2.4 times 5 is 12, and then divide by 3, and you get 4. You had that one already on the bell work. All right, let's go on. Number 19, look up here. Do I have more J's at the top or more J's at the bottom?
5.
How many more?
4.
It's actually 5, so be careful, okay? Do I have more K's at the top or more K's at the bottom?
K's at the top.
Is everybody clear? Those are so simple, don't miss those, okay? All right, let's go on. Number 20. It looks like we had this one already, didn't we? Well, it's very similar. So look up here. Put parentheses, minus 2 times A minus C, but these are different numbers. So A is a 3 that goes here. B is an 8 that goes there. And the C is a negative 5. So you're going to get a plus here. So you're going to get 8 minus 6 plus 5. 8 and 6 is 13, so that's 13 minus 6. And so that's going to give you 7, I think. Okay? Any questions on number 20? Is everybody clear on number 20? Look at your answers from yesterday. Make sure you're doing this right. All right, let's keep moving. 21. Watch this one now. Draw a line. Combine like terms. So 5 plus 1 is 6, 7, 8. So put 8D plus 6 equals 4D. Do I have more D's on the left or more D's on the right?
Left.
How many more on the left?
Four.
All right, four more, but that's not really what I want to do. So look here. Subtract 4D. So you're going to get 4D plus 6 equals 0. Don't be afraid to write 0. Any questions so far? All right, next. I want to subtract 6. So minus 6. So I get 4D equals negative 6 divided by 4. On your test tomorrow, you can use your calculator and say negative 1.5, I think it is. A negative divided by a positive is a negative. Say that to yourself. Make sure you know. Any questions on how to do number 21? All right, we're almost finished with the first page, and we are. So flip it over. I already worked number 22, so I'm not going to go there. Let's go to 23. The month of February, you sold 45, and because of a campaign, you sold 54 in March. What percent increase? Now, look, I never really taught you percent increase, but I'm going to tell you right now. So write this down. Percent increase or percent decrease is difference divided by original. Write that down. Difference divided by original. And this is what I do and how I do it. So clear your calculator. Let's subtract these two numbers. So put 54 and let's subtract 45. Well, I guess that's 9. Is that correct? So the difference is 9 divided by the original price. The original was 45. So take 9 divided by 45 and you're going to get 0.2. So it's a 20% increase is the answer. Because of that sale, you sold 20% more shoes than what you did before. Is everybody clear? Yes.
We're gonna have that question.
Yes, you are. And you might have it on the PERT test, okay? So it's difference divided by original. And you know what? This right here is really important. For example, let's say gas is about 218, let's say right now. Let's say it goes up to, say, $3. I want you to find the percent increase right now. Do it the same way. Find the percent increase. Remember the formula. Difference divided by original. Difference divided by original. I want you to do this problem. So subtract them and divide it by the original problem. This is really, really important. Like with your pay, when you get a job, you want to find out what your raise is. You figure it out this way. If they tell you they're going to give you a 10% raise, you know what it should be. All right, so the difference here is what, 82 cents?
Yeah.
All right. So put 0.82, 82 cents, divided by the original, which is 218. And let me just make sure on that. Okay, so 3 minus 2.18 is 82.82 divided by 2.18. I get 0.37. So it's a 37%. You got to move your decimal two places. Increase. Make sure you put that arrow. Now that means it's going up 37 cents on every dollar. That's a lot of money. That's a quarter and some nickels and a couple of pennies, okay? And that's substantial because you got to pay that when it goes up. That's a real cost. All right, number 24, the circulation of a newspaper decreased. This is percent decrease, so put 5,700, and then it went down to 3,960. Right now, I want you to figure out the percent decrease. Try that right now, please. Remember, difference divided by original. That's all you got to know. That's the way I did it. Difference divided by original. Do it right now.
Let me see what the difference is. So 5,700 minus 3,960, and I get 1,740 divided by 5,700. I get 30%, 0.30, so it's a 30% decrease. 30% decrease. So that one's a good thing if you're talking about spending money, if it goes down. All right, let's go on. Now, Pythagorean's theorem may or may not be on the PERT test, but it's definitely in geometry. So look up here. Put a dot. Color this box in. Be better. Color it in. Some of you like the color, so color it in. Now, this side has a color, and so does that one. This one does not. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? This one does not have a color on it. So I'm going to put these together. So put 8 squared plus 7 squared is equal to c squared. The ones with the box go together. Say it to yourself and memorize it, okay? I got kids in geometry, still don't understand that. And I want you to understand it. So this is 64 plus 49 equals c squared. So I take my calculator. And I take 64 plus 49, and I get 113. But I'm not finished, okay? So put 113 equals c squared. Now, you see this? You can't have that, so you got to do something called the square root. So on your calculator, take 113, hit shift, right way up here, hit shift, and then press the square root, which is right here. It's on the bottom. So put 10.6. Any questions on how to do Pythagorean's theorem? All right, let me give you one to try. All right. As practice. Just a few minutes, sir. So look up here. Draw this diagram. Put your box. And make this one 8, and make that one 5, and make that one X. Try that one. Okay, it's a little different than the one you did, but color your box. Okay.
And then use that formula. Color your box and use that formula.
Instead of C, use X.
I mean, yeah, you can use whatever you want. You can use X. All right, now watch, because you might be having a little trouble. So color this in. Which two go together?
8 and 5.
So it's going to be 5 squared plus X squared is equal to 8 squared. This one doesn't have a box, so this one goes by itself. The one without the box goes by itself. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? All right. So 5 times 5 is 25, so put 25. 8 times 8 is 64. Do you know how to solve that? Can anybody solve that? Well, I don't want to add 25. I mean, it's a plus, right? So you want to do a minus 25. So on your calculator, can you tell me what that is?
39.
All right, so put 39. Somebody double check and make sure. All right, so press shift, square root, and I get 6.2.
Oh, the square root of 39?
Yep, shit, because you got to get rid of that. So everybody clear on how to do Pythagorean's theorem, okay? Your algebra teacher tried to teach this to you, and I'm trying to teach you as well. Make sure you color the box, okay? So everybody clear on that? The one with the box, the ones go together. All right, let's go on. This one right here, it says evaluate. So watch how I do this. So put negative, and then put parentheses, negative 1 squared plus 3. A negative 1 times a negative 1 is a positive 1, but that negative makes it a negative. The answer should be 2. Any questions on what I did? Only the negative 1 is squared, but not that negative on the outside. There's no parentheses around it. Okay, I think I tried to teach that to you once before. All right, look up here. Use the quadratic equation. What is my A on this one?
3.
What is my B?
1.
There's no X. You got to know that, okay? I heard the wrong answer a few times on this one, so watch. It's AX squared plus BX plus C. C is the number. There's no X on this one. There's an X squared, but that's your A. There's no B. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? You got to be able to identify the A, the B, and the C, or you don't have a chance.
The B is 0.
The B is 0. But it's not what I heard some of you say. Is everybody clear on what I did? All right, so look up here and watch. So it's going to be X equals negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4 times A times C, all divided by 2 times A. So it's going to be 0 plus or minus 0. This is going to be a negative 12 over 6. So I'm going to get plus or minus the square root of negative 12 over 6. You cannot take the square root of a negative number, so it's no solution. Any questions on the quadratic equation for this problem? All right, let's go on. This one says find the common difference. We're getting close. All right, so look up here. Take your calculator and we're going to subtract backwards. You had this on a test a while back. So clear your calculator. Not right now. So you're going to get 2.3 and put a negative. Okay, 2.3 and a negative, and then press minus a negative 2. So minus a 2, but put a negative in front of it, and I get negative 0.3. Now I got to see if that works again. So clear your calculator. Catch up with me, okay? So press 2.6, and put a negative in front of it, and then press minus. Put 2.3 and put a negative in front of that. Make sure you put a negative in front, and I get negative 0.3. So the common difference, I'm just going to say, is that. Now, technically, we should check the last one. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? Everybody understands that? All right, let's go on. The next one right here, I'm not sure what they wanted, but I think it was slope. So put for number 29, put slope. Does anybody know the formula for slope? Y1 minus Y2 over X2, or it actually should be Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. Copy that down. That's the formula for slope. Which one do you think is my Y2?
9.2.
Good. So put XY and XY so you're not confused. So use this one. So it's going to be negative 9.2 minus a negative 5.2 over my X is negative 3.2 minus a negative 7.2. Try and work that, please. Try and work that problem. Use your calculator. This is a plus, by the way. Now, you know your algebra teacher tried to teach this to you. So press 9.2, put a negative, and then plus 5.2. I get negative 4 on that one. And then down here, I'm going to say 3.2, put a negative, and then plus 7.2. And so I get 8.45. Any questions on what I did? Should I double check that one? All right, let me check. 7.2 minus 3.2. All right, it is 4. So it should be a negative 4 over negative 4. Actually, it's a positive 4. So what's a positive? What's a negative divided by a positive? Any questions on how to do slope on number 29? Is everybody clear on that? All right. Let's keep moving. Number 30 is a two-step equation. Actually, no. They want to know the slope and the x and y intercepts. Is everybody with me so far? All right, let's cover up the x. What's my y intercept?
One.
Excuse me?
One.
Where do you see a 1 at?
Six.
Who can tell me what my y-intercept is? 54. That's your y-intercept. It's what y equals, Sarah. We're not looking for the number in front of the y. We want to know what y equals. What does x equal when I divide by negative 6?
Negative.
So put negative 9. Is everybody clear on the x and the y-intercept? All right. Let's solve this one for y. How do I solve that for y? Add 6x. So when I add 6x, I get y equals 6x plus 54. What's my slope here? That's my slope. So we did the x-intercept, we did the y-intercept, and we did the slope. Is everybody clear on that? Okay, we're getting closer. Again, all this is on your test. It says find a line parallel. Now, this is going to be a little harder, okay? So I need you to really pay attention. Sit up, please, Ocean. On this one right here, you're going to use the slope. So put y minus y equals m times x minus x. This is called point slope. Write that down. My y is 3, so put y minus 3 equals my slope, which is negative 5, and then it's x minus my x, which is a negative 6. You're going to have to be able to do that in geometry. This is called point slope formula. So you're using the slope. What is it you can't see? All right, let's keep moving. All right, this one says solve. Now watch this carefully. You see how my x's are lined up and my y's are lined up? If this one was a positive, these would drop off. So multiply this one by a negative. So it's going to be negative 7x plus 4y equals a negative 4. The bottom one stays the same. This is called elimination. This cancels. So I get a negative 6x is equal to negative 1 on that. And then I divide by negative 6. These are harder. Okay, I'm not going to tell you that they're not. So x is 1 over 6. Any questions on how I got x? All I did was change the signs on the top. Now you got to find y. So you got to pick which equation you like. I like this second one. So I'm going to say x, which is this. So put 1 over 6 minus 4y equals 3. You're going to clear your denominator. Okay? Some of you had Miss Rasick, and I know she taught you how to clear your denominator. So these cancel. So I get 1 minus 24y equals 18. I'm going to subtract 1. So I'm going to get negative 24y equals 17. And then I'm going to divide by negative 24. I'm going a little fast here, I know. This one is really kind of messy because I have fractions. Okay, hopefully tomorrow you won't. Much harder, all right. Let's go to number 33. Okay, look up here. Now watch this carefully, and I'm going to show you, instead of elimination, I'm going to show you substitution. Take all of this and circle it and substitute it in place of that y. So in place of that y, put 3x plus 8 is equal to 4x plus 7. Any questions about what I did so far? You were taught substitution method. You may not remember it. You could use either one. All right, so I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. This is variables on both sides. So I get x plus 7, and I'm going to subtract 7, and I got my answer. X is 1. Any questions on how I got my x? All right, now watch. You see where it says y? Put a x, put a 1 right there. What's 3 times 1? What's 3 plus 8?
11.
So y is 11. You're going to have to know this next year for geometry. And you need it on the PERT test. All right, we're going to stop right here.